We're back, Tim, and we're going to have a little fun. We came outside.
We are. We're outside in the elements, which we've told people.
I haven't been out all day, so I feel like... I guess it's time. I put the layers on.
The sun is out.
It's nice to see the sunshine.
It is nice to see the sunshine. So when we think about cold weather, we always think about these cool like experiments we can try to do. Now, the whole boiling water, they say that's better if it's got to be like minus 10 degrees at least.
Sub-zero temperatures.
Yeah.
Otherwise, that can be really dangerous because you're throwing boiling water into the air.
Yeah.
And you don't want to risk any of that not freezing and coming back and hitting you in the face. So... Please be extra cautious with that. We actually don't, it looks so cool, but we really don't encourage a lot of people to try that.
Yeah, because
maybe back on Sunday morning that was something we could have tried, but it's not cold enough today for that.
Yeah, not gonna get there. So what I've done is I researched it a little bit and said that bubbles will freeze in this temperature.
Yes, that is true. It's actually the water inside the soap that freezes and creates that kind of crystal bubble for you.
Okay, so this little contraption makes like a...
I'm always impressed with the little hacks that Tim comes up with.
This makes like a bubble caterpillar, bubble...
Okay.
So, see, well, it's pretty cool here. And earlier when I tried it, it was freezing when it hit the ground.
And they usually will break when that happens, so that's very cool. I love it.
So now if we let it... Let's see if it freezes.
Now it's in the sunshine. Look at the colors, though.
The colors are really good.
Do me a favor. Do that again, but blow it on top of the pile of snow that I brought over here.
Gotcha.
Maybe not quite as big, but just lay it gently, like put it right on that snow. Maybe. Yeah. Oh. But you can already see.
It's starting to crystallize.
Yeah, do you see how we can, like... already pick up the bubble without popping it. And we may start to see some of those bubbles.
Look, it's changing.
Yeah. So it'll cloud up as that water inside the bubbles there starts to freeze. And we'll get those, that more opaque kind
look
of
at that.
Magic, you know.
It's ball. Transforming as we speak. Look at that.
Very cool stuff. You can actually see the one on the ground in the sun is doing it too. Starting to cloud up a little bit. But yeah, blow that bubble onto a pile of the snow.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
And I just took like a piece of pantyhose over end.
This, ladies, if you are still a knee-high wearer, I know it's a little old school. They're great to have around. This is a great thing to do when they get a run in them. So change it into an experiment with your kids. I'll get you some more snow. Hold on.
Look at that. That is so, look at it now, Angela, look.
Oh, it's so cool.
The one we had.
There you go, a little longer.
It's morphing as we see. Look at that. Look at that. How it's broken in half because it froze.
Yeah. You have to be careful when you put them down because they will. I mean, this is almost like pop. I mean, you're not. I'm like popping bubble wrap almost, but because it's already iced up.
That's pretty cool.
So find those bubble wands you stuck away at the end of summer. Try this out. Put it down on the. It'll do it just in the air, but put it down on the snow and you can really.
See it make.
And I am impressed. I'm going to make this with Morgan. This.
And look, if you don't have bubble solution at home, I'll give you my formula right here.
Okay.
4 cups of water, 1 cup of dish soap, and 1/3 cup of honey.
The honey.
Honey substitute, for the glycerin.
The glycerin. Okay. I guess that makes sense. All right.
Yep.
Good
so
to know.
That's a little simple formula you can put together. A little water bottle, a little pantyhose. You can use a sock as well.
A straw. Just don't inhale too much.
Yeah. There it is. Look at that.
It's super
cool. That's awesome.
Science, everybody.
It's science. Cold weather science. Keep it here. We got more coming your way. It's Fox 2 News, 9 a.m.